Afternoon to seek Torcello Isle. That green, mosquitoed, mossy fen. To contemplate uncanny moments when the water flushed bright pink or cyclamen and synthesized an altered state. The daily turn of trippers bouncing from the boats gone flouncing down to buy and barter tourist lace. Then on to reverence and honour holy sites before their picnics, meets with rosemary and mace, and final hasty scramble for the water bus, deserted night conferring magic on the place. For all the 40 residents and me, the dark was altogether like a living state of grace. Such vastness, never tawdry, never opulent, like Casanova's City of the Golden Plate. I stayed for 20 timeless days and rarely took the boat to travel round at restless chugging pace the Lido, Grand Canal, Murano, Marco Square, or see the loud Venetian gondoliers race. Torcello, island with a secret inner lake, where emperor of birds, the noble heron, faced a rowboat navigated through those thick canals by Stefano, Franco's younger brother, who had traced a course for us to earth and heaven's interface.